A jailbroken PSP can do a whole lot more than just play PSP games. There are dozens of consoles worth of retro gaming classics available to you on the go through the power of RetroArch. I'm about to show you everything it takes to set up RetroArch on your PSP so you can play your favorite retro gaming consoles and even retro gaming handheld systems right now. Stick around, my friend, because you're about to learn something new. First up, download RetroArch from the RetroArch website. I've got it linked for you in the description. From the downloads page, scroll down until you see the section with the PSP logo. You'll find the download link directly underneath the PSP logo. Click to download the latest version. In your downloads folder, you'll need to uncompress the 7Z file that you just downloaded. You can save yourself some extra work by uncompressing this file directly into the downloads folder, not into a subfolder. Once the file's uncompressed, delete the 7Z file in order to eliminate clutter. Connect your PSP to your computer with the USB cable and activate the USB connection. Back at your PC, you'll have access to the memory stick contents, and if you have a PSP Go, you'll have access to internal storage. Close out the File Explorer window for the internal storage on your PSP Go if you have one. For every model of PSP, double-click into the PSP folder at the root of your memory card. Inside the PSP folder, you'll find a game folder. Navigate to that folder and double-click on it. This is where you'll need to copy the RetroArch folder from your downloads folder. Grab the RetroArch folder and drag and drop it into the PSP/game folder on your memory card. That's all you need to copy for now. We'll take a look at copying your content and system BIOS files in just a moment. For now, just disconnect your PSP from your PC. When your PSP is disconnected from your computer, you're ready to launch RetroArch for the first time. Use the D-pad to navigate over to the Game tab in the XMB. Scroll up to Memory Stick and select it with the X button. You'll find the RetroArch application here. Select it with the X button to launch it for the first time. You can expect the screen to go black for about 20 seconds. Don't worry, everything's fine, it's just loading. See, everything's good. The only thing you have to do at this point is use the D-pad to move the highlight arrow down to Quit RetroArch and select it with the circle button. This lets RetroArch set up key folders that you need on your memory card to proceed. Back at the cross-media bar of your PSP, use the D-pad to move all the way to the left back to settings. With your PSP still plugged into your PC with the USB cable, activate the USB connection again. Back on your computer, you'll see the memory card and if you have a PSP Go, the internal storage pop up. Close the File Explorer window for the internal storage if you have a PSP Go. Navigate back to the PSP folder and double-click on it. Inside this folder, you'll find a new folder here that's been created called RetroArch. Double-click into that folder. The ideal location for copying over your game content is the Downloads folder located here. Navigate to the Downloads folder and double-click on it. I'm going to copy over a sample ROM file that will let us test not only the ROM file, but the need for system BIOS as well. In this case, I have ROMs and system BIOS files pre-staged in a folder on the C drive called ROMs on C. I'm going to be transferring over a Mattel Intellivision game called Astro Smash. No matter which system and games you want to play, simply drag and drop them into the Downloads folder on the memory stick. Next up, let's copy the system BIOS files onto the memory stick so that you can use emulators that require them. In the File Explorer window for your PSP, go back one level in the navigation. You'll be back in the newly created RetroArch folder on your memory stick. Scroll down through the list of folders until you find the folder called System. Double-click into this folder. Navigate to the location where you have your system BIOS file stored on your computer. Once inside that folder, you can drag and drop over all of your system BIOS files or just press Ctrl+A on the keyboard. Then drag and drop all of your system BIOS files into this folder on your memory stick. At this point, you're done with your computer. You can close out any instances of File Explorer and disconnect your PSP from your computer over the USB connection. Back on your PSP, with the USB connection terminated, use the D-pad to navigate back to the Game tab. Scroll up to Memory Stick and select it with the X button. Once again, select RetroArch with the X button to launch it. At the RetroArch main menu, use the D-pad to scroll the highlight arrow down to Load Content and select it with the circle button. Use the D-pad to move the highlight arrow down through the list of choices to Downloads and select it with the circle button. You'll find the folders here that you copied over from your computer to your memory stick. Use the D-pad to move the highlight down to the one you want and select it with the circle button. Let's test and make sure that both the game ROM and the BIOS files are working correctly. Launch the game of your choice with the circle button. And again, expect a black screen for about 20 seconds or so while RetroArch does its magic. If you made it this far in the video, you just unlocked a bonus tip. To access controls like number pads, press and hold the right shift button on the PlayStation Portable. This pulls up an on-screen menu that you can use to access numbers, the number key, asterisk key, and other keys that are part of classic controllers with number pads on them. You can use the virtual keypad to make selections for in-game options and start your games, especially for consoles like Intellivision. There's one more important thing you need to do with your PSP here, and if you ignore this, you're missing out on all of the great possibilities your jailbroken PSP can provide you. Check out this video shown here on screen and linked in the pinned comment and description to learn how to play backups of your favorite PSP games.